Good morning friends, today we are going to continue the next part. In the last lecture we have discussed the assumptions of the valence bond theory. Today we are going to explain the change in potential energy during the approach of two hydrogen atoms from infinite distance by drawing P curve. What will happen when the two hydrogen atoms are far apart? The potential energy of each is independent of the other and arbitrarily set at zero. As you know, the two atom approaches, there is the attraction between them and the energy decreases. This continue and becomes minimum when atoms forms more. P shoots upward if the atom come closer. This lowering of the energy is because each electron now comes under the influence of the second nucleus, that is the nucleus of the other atoms. This attraction more than the compensated the electron and the nucleus repulsion. See, here it is a diagram. What will happen? First of all, they are far away from each other. What happens when the molecule is going to form? At that time, you know, any molecule is going to form. At that time, the two atoms are coming close together. What happened in case of the hydrogen molecule? Two hydrogen atoms are initially the far apart from each other. But when the molecule is forming, at that time what happens? The two atoms are coming closer. When they are coming closer, at that time what happened? The energy will get at particular value. You can see here in the diagram that is shown how the changes in the potential energy takes place while forming the molecule. See, they are far apart, then they are coming closer, then they are very close in forming the molecule. Discuss the wave mechanical treatment of the hydrogen molecule on the basis of it. Now we have to apply this wave mechanical thing. There are the two isolated hydrogen atoms which may be described by the wave function psi and psi. When I have represented the two hydrogen atoms, if the atoms are quite far apart, they do not interact. It can be represented as psi is equal to psi A1 plus psi B1. Psi B2, where 1 electron of the atom A, 2 is the electron of the atom B. When atom 2 is together, 2 from the molecule, the wave function will change, but still we may accept equation 1. Using equation, we can calculate the energy of the system where the molecules and atoms are brought gradually closer. You can see the curve F is represent increase in the energy when two approaching atoms are parallel. Curve A has minimum energy of that particular value is given. This is the wave mechanical treatment for this particular part. Just you have to remember this part. Internuclear distance is given here. Then they give the condition under which the covalent bond conforms. Covalent bond formation between the two atoms takes place by the overlapping of the atomic orbitals of the two component atoms. Only those atomic orbitals in the valence shell of each atom that have the unpaired electron of the opposite spin can take part in the overlapping. During overlap, the opposite electron spin cancel each other. The two electrons are shared by the two atoms and result in covalent bond. The number of covalent bonds formed by an atom is usually the same number of orbitals as electron available with the atoms. This is the main condition for the formation of this particular molecule. What are the conditions? Give the condition under which the covalent bond form. First of all, there should be the covalent bond formation between the two atoms takes place by the overlapping at atomic orbitals of two combining atoms. Their AOs of the two atoms should be overlap, then only those areas in the balance sheet of each item that have unpaired electrons or opposites can take part in the overlapping. During overlap, the opposite electrons being cancel each other. The two electrons are shared by the two atoms and the result in covalent bond formation. The number of covalent bond formed by an atom is usually the same number of orbital as electron available with the atom. These are the conditions required for the formation of the covalent bond that may come in the exam. Sometimes the question will be based on this particular part. With the suitable example, explain the relation between bond length, bond order and energy. As you know, the equilibrium distance at which the forces of repulsion is balanced by the forces of attraction and at which the atomic nuclei are held is called as the bond length. The number of covalent bond formed between the two atoms in the given molecule is called as the bond order. Bond length and the bond order are related. Bond order is directly proportional, inversely proportional to the bond length. Amount of energy released per mole at the time of overlapping or bond formation is called as bond energy or bond formation energy. In formation of the bond, greater the overlapping, greater is the energy set free or released. That is the higher will be the bond length, greater overlap, shorter distance between the nuclei. Bond order is directly proportional to bond energy. The order of bond length between two atoms, as in the order of A, triple bond A, A double bond A, A single bond A. Triple bond dissociation energy will be greater than double bond dissociation energy as compared to the single bond dissociation energy that is given here. With the increase in the bond order, bond dissociation energy also increases. Here again, bond order, bond length and bond energy. For carbon, triple bond, what will be the energy that is given? It is more. For double bond it is 158 and for the single bond here about 83. Here 1.2, 1.34 and 1.54. You can see the distance is bond length is shorter for this triple bond, but for the single bond it is a greater. We got this point. What are the relation between this bond length, bond order and the particular bond order, bond length and the bond energy? You can see as the more is the bond, lesser will be the distance and energy will be the more. As you can see here, triple bond, double bond and single bond. For the triple bond, the energy is more, whereas the bond length is the smaller, because what happens when the three bonds are getting formed at that time, they are coming closer to each other and due to that their distance is less. Okay, the overlapping at the greater extent shorter will be the bond, and the greater overlapping is the lesser extent, then there will be the longer will be the bond. These things are there. This table you have to remember while writing this. While writing this answer, you have to write this table, because this table will indicate all the summary of this particular answer. Sometimes that question may come, what is the relation between the bond order, bond length and bond energy for the molecule. When the molecule once formed, at that time you know there will be the bond length, bond order and the bond energy. Okay. Here we have seen the simple example, carbon triple bond, carbon double bond and a carbon single bond. Please remember this thing. Please prepare it well. It is very simple part. Please go through this particular thing. Conditions for this is important part and this question is also the important. Okay. This whatever the PE diagram you have seen, just it is for your reference. To go through this particular part, please prepare this part well. Thank you.